Welcome back to the channel. We continue on with our Kentucky Derby contender videos for 2022. This time around, we're going to take a look at the Bluegrass Stakes winner. He goes by the name of Zandon. He's one of two Z horses in the Kentucky Derby, both owned by Minnesotans. You've got Zandon and Zozos. Zandon picked up the victory in the Bluegrass, his second start of 2022. He's only started four times in his career, so he should be fresh going into the Kentucky Derby starting gate. When you look at that leaderboard for Kentucky Derby 148, Zandon is one of the 100-point winners, joining White Abario, the Florida Derby winner, Cyberknife, the Arkansas Derby winner, Taiba, and Epicenter, who stayed down at that fairgrounds. And that Risen Star Louisiana horses seeming to be a little bit of the better top class this year. You had Epicenter, who defeated Smile Happy and Zandon in the Risen Star. Epicenter came back to win the Louisiana Derby. Zandon came back to win the Bluegrass, and Smile Happy second in the Bluegrass. Zandon, the pedigree, he's by Upstart, 15 starts, 4 wins. You know, he was good as a 2-year-old, started off as 3-year-old with a couple of nice efforts in the Fountain of Youth and the Florida Derby. He ran in a knockdown, dragdown Florida Derby. It was a very strong headwind. It was a slow final time, but it just kind of seemed to take the starch out of him. Didn't really come back until his 4-year-old campaign. He did win the Razorback. He was third in the Whitney. But I still say maybe his second place finish in a very strange track conditions in the Florida Derby when he was a 3-year-old might have been his career best race. Of course, he didn't have a lot of foals as a stallion. He's been lightly received. We'll talk more about that. On the mare side, you've got Creative Cause is the broodmare sire. He was a lightly raised horse, ran in the Kentucky Derby, ran in the Santa Anita Derby. He was a good mile and an eighth horse. He's another one that got a lot of foals his first couple of crops, so I think we'll see him for a few years here on the broodmare sire board. He was by Indian Charlie, and that brings a little bit of speed to the table. The mare family, not a lot of class in this pedigree. The first mare was unraced. The second mare only had one lifetime start, no wins in that one start. So the fact that they went to the Keeneland September sale and paid $170,000 for an upstart out of an unraced mare, there must have been something that they were looking at that maybe got the intrigue there, because $170,000, definitely more than some of the other foals at Upstart. But he's had a good crop here for this year. Of course, Zandon, the winner of the Bluegrass. You got Kathleen O, who's undefeated, trained by Shug McGahee. They are going to be one of the top four favorites for the Kentucky Oaks on the first Friday in May. Then you've got Reinvestment Risk, who just ran second in the Grade 1 Carter Stakes. And then you've got MicroShare, who ran a big maiden race, ran in the Santa Anita Oaks. And all of that is really out of not very many foals to race in 2022. Connections, Chad Brown, of course, second in the Kentucky Derby with Good Magic after winning the Bluegrass Stakes. He chased Justify all the way around the track and running second in his Kentucky Derby. Normandy Invasion made a huge move into the turn in his Kentucky Derby, flattened out a little bit, so he's been close there. And then his best training job may have been Practical Joke running fifth, but he was basically a miler. He got a good ride that year from the jockey and really was kind of trained up to the tee to get that mile and a quarter distance. Flavien Prat, of course, picked up the mount for the Bluegrass. Nice ride. He saved some ground. He was last early. Now, it's a little bit discerning for Zandon. Early on in his first start, he had a little bit more speed. Then he made a mid-race move in the Remsen Stakes. Came from off the pace after breaking slow in the Risen Star, and then now was back to last down the backstretch. He needs to show more speed as you look towards the Kentucky Derby. Of course, Flavien Prat won the Kentucky Derby officially with Country House, who was awarded that victory after Maximum Security on the disqualification. Speed figures steadily improving. His maiden special weight was a 93, but he split horses that day at Belmont. Then he went to the Remsen, picked up a 93. He was interfered near the wire. There was a Stewards' inquiry into that race. A lot of people thought Zandon should have been put up. They left it Mo Donegal over Zandon. And then in the Risen Star, he broke slow and went wide. Smile Happy saved ground. Zandon went wide. And then Zandon beat Smile Happy on the square in the Bluegrass, which he picked up a 107. So he had had those back-to-back-to-back 93s, and he really upped his game in a 107. That's the highest equibase speed figure on the Kentucky Derby prep races. So far, he's shown some versatility off the pace in all of his races. He needs to probably show a little bit more speed, but it looks like his gallop outs through the Remsen and his Risen Star going wide and covering a lot of ground in that race, he should be able to get the mile and a quarter of the Kentucky Derby. Odds-wise, I think he'll be one of the top five favorites. Flavien Prat rides, Chad Brown trains, and a 107 speed figure in the equibase scale. He had a 98 buyer speed figure in that race and only four lifetime races, so maybe a little bit of room for improvement from Zandon. Overall, a stamina-influenced pedigree, but not a strong female family, unraced for the mare and second mare, one start. What do you think of Zandon on the Kentucky Derby? Leave a comment. We've got Kentucky Derby contender videos with Cyberknife, Epicenter, Zozos, and Tawny Port as we bring you up to the first Saturday in May.